Hey,
ahoy sailors, welcome on board.
In this episode we will continue our trip around the Danish island Funen. The trip in total will be around 160-170 miles, but today it's only around 30, and we are going to visit a small island called Æbelø. It's a lonely island, nobody is living on it, and the whole island is under nature protection. So please come along, and I hope you will enjoy the trip.
Half past seven, and we just got off. A little later than expected, but it was a tough day yesterday for newbie sailors. We just started the engine, and Alan is fresh. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Yes, I'm okay fresh.
And it's a beautiful view here.
Yeah.
The island Vansø, which we visited yesterday.
Yeah. A lot of noise came there from last night. The deer were calling all night. But it was kind of cool. I liked it.
Ah. I'll take up the anchor.
Oh,
Og nemmere at spille det.
Ja, har det været for.
It's a beautiful morning in Lillebælt. And we are heading north. Our goal today is an island called Æbelø. So the north of Fyn. I can show you on the map. We are here at the moment. Island Æbelø.
So I just discovered the first technical problem. I could see that the engine, the generator was not making any power on the battery. But luckily the previous owner installed a second generator on the engine, and I always take it off because it just consumes extra power, extra diesel fuel. And now I just switch it on again, and now we have power and can continue. So maybe we should have a look at it later today to see if we can find any problems. But yeah, until now we can continue the trip without going into a harbor and looking for a mechanic or anything. That's what happens. Two bridges going from Jutland to Fyn. The first one is the old bridge, around 80 years old. I think the tea is ready.
It's boiling.
Yep.
Morning tea.
Yeah.
The chocolate tea.
Exactly. It's wonderful. Good in the morning cold. Chillness.
How's the temperature?
16, 15? Yes, yeah. And then a little chill factor from the wind. Yes, come a little more wind. Is it?
It's always interesting if you can, if the mast fits under the bridge. If Alan fits under the bridge.
Yeah.
Fuck the head, fuck the head.
Because of the problem with our trips, we are again eating the pork meat. I'm doing some slow cooking here to make sure that there's no bacteria alive when we eat it. Now we have visual contact with Æbelø. There's still no wind at all, and we have been running by engine the last 5 hours, like the whole trip. Now we are entering Æbelø. Hvad sagde du, Adam? Så hvis du prøver at slå den i bak. Og slå den i bak. Bakgear. Prøv at bakke. Jeg tror, den fik fat. Prøv at sætte lidt mere i, lidt kraftigere bakke, lidt mere i gas. Det er stille her, hva'? Det ser bare fedt ud, hva'?
It's warm,
yeah.
Very warm, and I just stressed out getting in the dinghy. I have need to practice a lot more, I guess. What? I'm still dry, that's a good thing. So
my feet is not dry, the water is coming in again.
Oh no, yeah. We have to row in a hurry.
In a hurry. The water's not as clear as yesterday.
Is it?
It's not as clear as yesterday, the water.
No. It's hard to see anything at all. Old man.
Old man on the sea.
Yeah.
That's tough.
Yeah, pretty.
Nice view. Yeah. Now we are walking on Æbelø, and we are taking a course towards the lighthouse. We saw from the coastline. Oh, look, there's a smart frog. And we're gonna explore the geological landscape of Æbelø. It consists of several layers of clay
And it means that these layers, they move. The upper layer, they kind of slide into the ocean and bring the trees with them. So what is it? Oh yeah, it's a deer. It's a deer. That is dog camera. It's the prehistoric forest of Æbelø. We just saw a sign saying that walking is only allowed on the path because of the animals. And in the middle of the island, there's a sea eagles are breeding. And it's not the season now, but they should be left alone. Now we found a watchtower. You're going to check it out. It's just incredible silence here.
Wow.
Looks like an African savannah.
Hello.
How do you like this island, Æbelø, compared to Tromsø?
Well, I like them both, but this island is so much more interesting. The fact is that the animals here, there were actually more animals at the other island, but here it seems like they are more natural. Nothing is touched, and it seems so original, prehistoric almost. That's just nice. And yeah, and now we have the opportunity to walk here and watch the animals and the nature. It's totally stunning, wonderful.
How about this path that we're walking on? Is that okay, or should we be allowed to walk all over the island?
Yeah, I think it's very, very okay, because the ordinary people have the opportunity to go here and watch the animals and learn about them. And if they were granted to run all over the place, the animals would be stressed and all the vegetation would be in time probably destroyed. And so I think it's very good that they have made those paths, and there are actually several of them, so there's no problem. And like I said, it's wonderful that the ordinary people as us, we can go here and enjoy the nature.
It's just amazing that you can hear them breathe. Ah, Mr. Alan, how was your day? Are you tired?
Yeah, yeah. I'm very tired.
Me too.
Yeah.
It was a lot of experiences today.
It was, the clock is about 9:30.
Yeah.
Yeah, and a lot of experiences, and that makes you tired, but wonderful feeling.
Yeah.
So much.
Something is bumping around.
Yeah.
Is that outside?
It's outside.
Yeah. We had anchor at Æbelø, and now it's bedtime.
Yeah.
Good night.
Good night.